Hi everyone, and welcome to our tutorial on how to cite references in IEEE style. My name is Paul Hottinger. I'm your engineering librarian here at Cal Poly Pomona.
And I'm Julie Shen. I'm the computer science librarian here at Cal Poly Pomona. IEEE style is a popular citation style used by engineering and computer science students. And in this tutorial, we're going to show you how to create in-text citations, footnotes, and references for a variety of different sources that you may come across in your library research.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about in-text citations. In-text citations are the citations that you put within the text that you're writing. So you're attributing an idea that you have included in your paper, in your project, to an author and giving credit where credit is due within the text, so the person who's reading it knows where the information came from. The in-text citations in IEEE format are numbered and appear in the order of appearance in the text in the form of footnotes. So on this second bullet point here is an example of a idea that someone has used in their paper, and they're attributing that idea to the author. So for example, some vibration and noise sources give rise to annoyance to people and every so often damage to property. Vibration in either digital or analog panel meters can cause their malfunction or difficulty in reading the meters, bracket one. So what they did here is the information that they used from their source, they're attributing that information to a source. If you do have more than one source that you're using within your paper, if you're using it together to form one idea, you'll see here on the second sentence that the bracket two, comma, and then bracket three is attributing source number two and three from your list of works cited to this idea that is within your paper. This is what your references at the end of your paper would look like. Your citations are listed in number order, not in alphabetical order. Many other citations you may have used in the past have authors in alphabetical order. In IEEE format, they use number order as they are used in your paper. All right, so now let's look at the anatomy of an IEEE citation. We're going to look at a journal article, and we'll go through each part that is necessary to create a valid citation for your works cited page. So this is the example we're going to use. It has all the necessary parts to make a valid citation. We put all this information in here, so that way whoever's reading your paper can look at this citation and know exactly where it came from. They have all the necessary pieces to find this, whether it's in their library, Google Scholar, wherever they are, so they can find exactly the source that you were using. So let's go through each part. So the first part of the citation is the footnote. That was that number that attributes to where it was within your text, that in-text citation. So in your in-text citation, there is number one somewhere. This is what it is attributed to. So this is the first citation within your paper. The next part are the authors. And in IEEE format, you cite the authors with the author's first initials or middle name, you know, first initials. So this is R-E-H. And then their full last name, all right, Wirtz. And if there's more than one author, you just put a comma and then put the next author. So this is S period, Perser, comma, et cetera, with a comma at the end. After the author comes the title of the article. This is the title of the article that they wrote. And you put this in quotes. So this is, quote, assessing information literacy skills demonstrated in an engineering design task, comma, end quote. After the title of the article, you need to include the title of the journal. This is the journal that the article lives in, the journal that published it. So in this case, it's the Journal of Engineering Education with a comma after it, and make sure that the title of the journal is in italics. Next is the volume number. It is written as VOL period, then the number, in this case, 102 with a comma after it. The next part is the issue number. And that is written as NO period, then the number. So in this case, 4, followed by a comma. After that comes the page numbers. And that is written as PP period, and then the range of the page numbers. So in this case, it's 577-602, followed by a comma. And lastly is the year that it was published. And it's written in month and then year. And for the month, you use the abbreviation. So in this case, October is OCT. And then you put the year that came out, followed by a period. And these are all the necessary components put into a citation. That way, you know exactly where that source came from. Now, obviously, there are more types of sources than just journal articles, so let's go through a few of the more popular type of sources that are used within engineering and computer science. This first one, let's go through the anatomy of an IEEE citation of a conference proceedings. So here's an example of a conference proceeding. It's the footnote along with the author. Make sure the title of the conference proceeding is in quotes. Difference here is after the title of the conference proceeding in quotes, afterwards you put in and then the title of the conference. So in this case, it's the in of the proceedings of the 14th ACM International Conference on Web Search and Data Mining. Then you put comma, put the month and year that the conference proceeding came out, the page numbers, and then this one has a DOI at the end. The DOI is a digital object identifier. This is a permanent web address that you can find this conference proceeding.
Great. So now we're going to take a look at preprints, which is a special type of publication that happens because often these experts in engineering and computer science want to share their work before it's officially published. And so what results are called preprints. There are several different places online where these experts share their preprints, and one of the most popular places is on arXiv.org. And so here you see, if you want to cite a preprint, you follow the same format, you number it in your references, and then you include the author information, the title of the preprint, along with the URL on arXiv, along with the date that you accessed it. This is only when the preprint hasn't been officially published yet. Once the preprint has become available as a final version in either a journal or a conference proceeding, you need to change your citation so that you're citing the final version. So here you see that the preprint is now published in the IEEE CVF International Conference on Computer Vision. So that's what you need to be citing, including the year and the actual page numbers and the DOI.
All right, the next citation we want to show you is how to cite an ebook, electronic book, in IEEE citation. So for an ebook, what you include, of course, is the footnote in brackets, include the authors in IEEE format, and then you'll include the title of the book is written in italics. After the title comes the city and state that the publisher is from. So in this case, it's comma, Berkeley, California, followed by a colon, and then the name of the press, so it's a press, and then the year that it was published. So this was published in 2021. Since this is an ebook, after the date, we'll include in brackets online to state that this book is an electronic book, and then provide the URL where they can access the ebook.
Our next example is how to cite software, which is a common source used by engineering and computer science students. So here again, you will see that it's numbered, and then you have the author's name, or in this case, it's the name of the organization that came together to create the software. Following the author, you have the year of the software. This is especially important because software often gets updated and you need to be using the most current version. Following the year, you have the name of the software and the accessed date, along with the word online in brackets. And finally, you have the word available along with a link to where the reader can expect to find the software and download it.
Okay, the next one is the anatomy of a standard in IEEE citation. So to cite standards in IEEE format, you start off with the footnote in brackets. So in this case, it's number 6. After the bracket comes the title of the standard, and you italicize the title of the standard, followed by a comma. Then you have the number of the standard. So in this case, it's C37.95-2014. So that's the number of the standard that you're using, followed by a comma and the month and year that the standard came out, followed by a period. Now, since this standard was coming from online, from IEEE Explorer, I'm going to put in brackets online after it, followed by a period, and then the URL where you can access this standard. If you'd like more examples of citations, you can access our libguide of our citation tutorials from the following URL and learn more about IEEE as well as the other citation formats that are out there.
Thank you for joining us for this tutorial. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us at our email. Paul Hottinger is available at prhottinger@cpp.edu and Julie Shen is available at jshen@cpp.edu.